There have been some really interesting conversations happening around Baldur's Gate 3 over the past few months related to how this is going to impact the industry as a whole and where do companies go from here in terms of how they're developing their games. Because when you look at what Baldur's Gate 3 did, they sort of did all the things that other companies said are impossible. It's too risky. We can't do that. We need to stick to the things that are tried and true. We've got our Marvel method here of making games that are free to play, monetized with cash shops and microtransactions. Everything's live service these days, because that's how we make the most amount of money. And Larian Studios came along and said, we're not only going to not do any of that, we're also going to do it with a CRPG, which traditionally is not one of those blockbuster best-selling titles when you compare it to things like God of War, Jedi Survivor, all of these, single-player RPG storylines, Elden Ring, those types of games. So to have a CRPG swoop in and just take the Golden Joystick Awards by storm, and not only win Ultimate Game of the Year, but also win more awards than any other game has ever won since The Witcher 3, it does set a precedent for what's to come. And we've talked about in the past how not every game needs to be Baldur's Gate 3. Not every game needs to be this huge, epic, scoped game with 300 hours of gameplay, right? We can still have these streamlined 25 to 40 hour experiences, aka God of War, Jedi Survivor, so on and so forth, Spider-Man 2. Hopefully we can avoid things like Modern Warfare 3 with its little 3 hour campaign that they charged $70 for. But I would argue that there is room for every game company out there now to look at what Larian Studios did with Baldur's Gate 3 and realizing that there are some core tenets that are very important to game design, and they are more important, or they can be more important, than monetization or get game as a service. And that is simply creating a good game with great storytelling and doing it in a way that is relatively bug-free upon launch. Not completely. Baldur's Gate 3 has had a lot of issues. Out of the gate, Act 1 was pretty good, Act 2 was okay, Act 3 was a buggy hot mess. But when you compare it to, say, some of the, Assassin's Creed games that have launched over the years, and some other games that have had extremely buggy launches, Cyberpunk 2077 coming to mind, which, by the way, redeemed itself completely with the 2.0 update and winning Expansion of the Year with Phantom Liberty at the awards ceremony, coming full circle from that. But, Larian proved that you can do it, that you can actually just build a good game. And it reminds me, what's that phrase from the Kevin Costner baseball movie? If you build it, they will come, I think is the phrase. What is it? Field of Dreams was the name of that movie. I blanked for a minute on that film. It's an old movie. But it, Larian kind of did prove that that's the case. If you build it, they will come. But you have to do a few things first. You have to have a passion for storytelling. You have to have a big enough budget to make it polished and good, and even if you are indie, be able to give it that triple A level of quality. If you want to achieve the recognition and sales numbers and everything else that Baldur's Gate 3 did. And this is more for, big companies. I would argue that indie companies don't have to worry about it too much. We have companies like Tactical Adventures who made Celasta. That game was amazing at a much lesser scope than Baldur's Gate 3. You have companies like Owlcat Games, who also make great CRPGs at a much lesser scope than what Larian did with Baldur's Gate 3. You also have Obsidian Entertainment, who over the years have made critically acclaimed games. Not always best-selling games, but critically acclaimed CRPGs with a pedigree that goes back to the Black Isle days. Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, Icewind Dale 1 and 2, Neverwinter Nights 1 and 2, KOTOR 1 and 2. It's very interesting to see Baldur's Gate 3 rising through to the cream of the crop, rising through the cream of the crop to the top, when it is one of those games that is not in what many people would be that traditional best-selling game genre, which is the CRPG. And I think it just shows a lot of it is, great game, also great community around the game, but also I think great communication from Larian Studios and the way that they did the early access for 3 years and having those big events, the panels from hell where they would come in and rent a whole castle and Swin would show up in full armor and just showing everybody, letting their nerd flags hang, as opposed to a lot of these other companies. I would say that, as much as I love Red Dead Redemption 2, Rockstar is not the same type of entity. They're a giant corporate beast, and they don't interact with their fans the same way Larian Studios does. I would argue that most game companies don't do what Larian did in terms of community engagement, the CEO being out there with everybody, being a nerd in full armor, having bands come on and sing songs, and everybody's cosplaying, and they're renting out castles, and they're just showing people that we can have fun while we're creating a really good game, and we can all be part of this adventure together. It doesn't have to be this separation between the entity creating the game and the gamers. We can all be part of this. And I think it's also celebrating the culture of Dungeons and Dragons and what tabletop has meant to people for generations. I am of the second generation of D&D kids. I grew up on second edition. I do love first edition. I learned how to play on first edition, but I grew up with second edition being the generation edition for my generation. And I actually prefer second edition AD&D to all other editions because of that. But we're on fifth edition now, and I technically we're on to the sixth edition now with this new D&D thing that they're doing. But Larian has managed to take that, the heart and the core of what tabletop is, which is community games, gameplay with your friends, and made a game that is in the spirit of the first two Baldur's Gate games with great companions, great writing, great voice acting, great mocap. I mean, the fact that we had, Asterion winning an award for his talent, the actor behind him doing all the voiceover and mocap, and all of these people really helping breathe life into these characters. Larian building a motion capture studio from scratch to support this game. Not many companies out there are going to be willing to do that, much less be in a position to do that if they're an indie studio, because we're talking, a tens of millions of dollar investment to make something like that happen. And it obviously paid off in spades for them. But for companies that already have mocap studios, I would argue that CD Projekt Red is already doing a great job. Remedy is doing a great job. Alan Wake 2 is amazing. Cyberpunk is an amazing experience. I can't wait to see what it's going to come next for those studios. And even though I realize that it is a long gestating, who knows when it's going to see the light of day thing, Squadron 42, watching its feature complete trailer recently, even though, yes, it doesn't have a launch date, and I am critical as hell of them, and I don't believe anything that comes out of Chris Roberts' mouth in terms of timelines or anything else. If you watch the feature complete trailer and gameplay videos that came out around CitizenCon, that is shaping up to be another level of cinematic storytelling that's going to carry people into the future of gaming. And so I think now when companies look to what Larian did with Baldur's Gate 3, we can now see that, hey, you don't have to only create Marvel tentpole style games, meaning the God of War, Jedi Survivor, on the rails linear experiences. If you want to have 20 million copy games, like if you want to sell tens of millions of copies, all you got to do is build a good game. It doesn't really matter the genre, as long as you can produce it at a triple A level. And if you can do what Larian did and swing for the fences and hit a home run, the sky's the limit. But again, the question is Baldur's Gate 3 a unicorn in this environment, or will other companies be able to use this as a springboard to inspire them to try to achieve to these standards and create the next evolution of gameplay? Because we're in 2023, almost 2024 now, and quick commercial break, everyone, to celebrate and give thanks to all of these amazing people who keep me on the air full time. Really appreciate the support. All you got to do is join as a member. You get access to private videos. You can also do super thanks on any upload or super chats and stickers on any live stream or premiere you see. And beyond that, don't forget we're multi-streaming over on Twitch now, so you can support over there as well. Thanks so much to everybody. Let's get back to the video at hand. We've still got another 6 years ahead of us for the rest of this decade. So unless someone wants to let Baldur's Gate 3 take the Game of the Decade award, which it totally should, and well, at this point, if no other competition comes out, companies have 5 or 6 years now to create something of this caliber or better and get it out there in the public. The one thing that I hope we take away from this as a genre is the understanding that CRPGs aren't just a tiny little niche. Turn-based gameplay isn't just a tiny based niche. By the way, I've been very open about this. I was not a huge supporter of turn-based gameplay until Baldur's Gate 3. I've always been a real-time with pause. I now have a greater appreciation for turn-based gameplay after putting, 1,000-plus hours into all these playthroughs of these characters. I'm going through Wasteland 3 right now because one of the reasons I didn't finish that game when it came out was because I was like, it's turn-based gameplay, meh. And now I'm going off of Baldur's Gate 3, going to that game and going, oh, this is actually quite good. I'm playing Rogue Trader. That's the big thing I'm prepping for right now. That's coming out December 7th. That's the next game from Owlcat. So if you liked the first two Pathfinder games they did, this is a Warhammer game. And it's, of course, a lesser scale and lesser scope than what Baldur's Gate 3 is, but it's turn-based gameplay with rich, deep mechanics and super amazing lore that goes back decades. That's providing me, it's scratching an itch that I previously didn't really know needed to be scratched because I was always looking the other way when turn-based games came out. I love my CRPGs, Baldur's Gate 1 and 2, Icewind Dale 1 and 2, Neverwinter Nights 1 and 2, KOTOR, Dragon Age Origins, Pillars of Eternity 1 and 2, but those games all have real time with pause. So to play a game with turn-based gameplay that's also a CRPG done in the way that Larian Studios did Baldur's Gate 3, I think the sky is the limit for companies that are willing to sit up and pay attention and realize that you don't have to just create games as a service to create best-selling titles. You don't have to create single-player on-the-rail linear experiences to create best-selling titles. All you really need to do is have a passion for what you're building, make a good game, and if you build a good game, and you have a great leadership team and a great community, and you're willing to be out there, fix mistakes when they happen, and don't screw people over, and don't use shady marketing tactics and all this other stuff, I think you're seeing the results. You're seeing the results. And I, for one, am wholeheartedly in Larian Studios camp now. I was not before this game. I talked about this before. I didn't know anything about them before Baldur's Gate 3 was announced. I then went and played Divinity Original Sin 1 and 2 and went, they're good games, but not my favorite, but they're good games, and I could see how they are capable as a team, and they should be able to pull something off, make a Baldur's Gate 3 that is enjoyable at least. And then I played Baldur's Gate 3, and I went, oh my god, you guys not only did everything I hoped you would do, you also went like 10 steps beyond, cranked it all the way up to 11, and sent all the competition home going, shit, we're going to have to change our game to make better games for the future, because Larian just showed us all up. And now, we as consumers, the gamers, consumer awareness has never been higher. And now with this understanding that we've seen that a company can make a great game that doesn't have microtransactions, that doesn't have a bunch of paid cosmetics and everything else, it's not a game as a service, it's just a great game that you can buy and play and get 300 hours or more out of it. It's a good time to be a gamer, everybody. The next 5 to 6 years are going to be super cool to see what comes out from all these other studios, and I, for one, can't wait to be a part of it. Like, subscribe, hit the bell icon so you never miss an update. Check out all the playlists here on YouTube. We're multi-streaming on Twitch now, so follow us there as well. Join the Discord. Links are down below, and I'll see everybody in the next video. Till then, stay safe. Larian, you guys are rock stars. We'll see you in the next one. Cheers.